Hello, folks. Reverend Crystal Cox here. I don't personally believe in mega churches. I watch these shows online and I hear about these churches that have thousands and thousands of people. And some of them don't even have a pastor or someone in the front, they just have a video screen. They're all giving money to the ministry. They're all, I don't know if they're craving for something greater or what it is. I mean, they could give their money to some local church or local nonprofit or something and do more in the world, I think. We at Bringing Back Goddess Church, which I also call Mother Goddess Church, what it is about to us is nurturing the one person. Okay, so it's not about standing in a room of thousands of people and reading the Bible. It's about teaching that person to listen to their own inner guidance, to build a relationship with Spirit, Buddha, Jesus, the Great Spirit, saints and angels, Mother God, Father God, whatever feels right for them and feels kin to them. It's not about coming to church every Wednesday and Sunday, for example, and listening to someone else read the scriptures. If you're trying to build a relationship with God through the biblical scriptures, then we would teach you how to pray and connect with God directly, studying the Bible, studying Jesus' life, asking for guidance and asking for help, and working direct. So we teach you to trust yourself, trust your own inner guidance, how to work with your own guides, how to trust who you really are, and not necessarily to lean on us or who we might have giving a talk or some sort of sermon. When you have one person talking to thousands and thousands of people on a Sunday, to me, that's just not where our belief system is. We believe in teaching people one-on-one how to heal their body, heal their mind, heal their soul. Talking to them, giving them spiritual counseling on what's going on with them personally. Giving them tips to create a better life for themselves and ways to help the planet and to help their friends and their neighbors and their community, and doing this one-on-one. The person standing up in front of thousands of people, they do reach them and they do have a great message quite often. I've listened to quite a few of these, and they are inspiring. However, if that's just not what we are. So believing in that is, I'm not saying that's a bad thing. You need to trust yourself. But if I just personally don't ever want to do the mega church thing, I believe more in the Great Mother. You know, having homes and having a female clergy and bringing back the feminine divine, and people come into the home and they pray and they get spiritual counseling and they heal and they learn tools how to make their lives better, make their jobs better, make their own personal family and choices better, healing their body, mind, soul, and spirit. And we teach them that through a clergy of women. And instead of a giant mega church, we do that through homes, through bringing them into our home and nurturing them and healing them and spiritually counseling them. And then we also have, you know, kind of class settings, and we do videos online and we teach people this stuff, but not in a way that I personally believe renders them powerless, but in a way that makes them all leaders, all spiritual leaders, all healers, all teachers, so that they go on and they help many more. Not as in keep coming back to us so that we can fulfill you, but teaching them how to be better and stronger at who they are. And we are certainly in no way against men. However, we are a woman clergy. We are a goddess ministry. We are about bringing back the feminine divine and helping to empower women. And we also do spiritual counseling for men and help them with their calling. And it's just that our ministers, our pastors, are women. And as I said, instead of a church where thousands and thousands of people come, we're doing it through households and through, you know, actual mother nourishing and helping and healing. And so it actually is a different venue of tithing. So donations to our church, you know, we solicit online, we solicit from big corporations, and we help, you know, like we help women and children that are homeless. We help people in domestic violence situations. We help people that have been through sexual trauma of all ages. we have many different things that we do, but instead of doing it through a church and trying to get more and more people into one big room or building so that we can essentially give one lecture, we do it on a, you know, person to person, making the life of one person better. So we're spending the day with that person. We're healing them. They might get massage or juicing, study spiritual information, study scripture and doctrine, or, you know, swim or hike or pray or, you know, whatever it is that that person needs to nurture them. And we intuitively know. The pastors at Bringing Back Goddess Church are very intuitive, very clairvoyant, healers, light workers, psychics. And we do energy work and spiritual work, and really to empower that person to then go and empower many others, instead of having them come back to us all the time in a setting of thousands of people. Sure, they'll keep coming back and seeking guidance. We all seek guidance from each other and from other people. You know, you never stop learning. It's just that we've chosen the format of the Great Mother, which is the ancient tradition of, you know, the house in the forest or whatever, the house on the beach, you know, going to see the sage, the oracle, the Delphi, the, you know, these women that have knowledge and healing power and information and wisdom. And you go and see them, and they give you wisdom on all these different levels, and then you go away, and then you come back. You might come back at a later date, but to us, that's just more nurturing and wholesome, and that's just how we do Mother Goddess Church. So thanks for listening, and Goddess bless you all.